and good morning on this Tuesday morning. 62 degrees out there. Time to wake up.
Hey, y'all can't tell if my hand's swollen, can you?
Just a bit.
I think I stung a couple of wasps yesterday. But anyway, I survived the night. Hey, good morning. I'm Jamie Cooper. Thank y'all for getting up with us. This is Athens in the AM on a good-looking, I mean cool, Tuesday morning in Athens, Limestone County, Alabama. Frank, Abby, Brad, everybody in ready to rock and roll on a Tuesday morning. Dr. Jan White. Dr. White, what is your subject on this Tuesday morning?
Staying fit for life.
All righty.
Yay.
Ain't got nothing to do with magic ropes, does it?
No.
Okay, well, good. We'll start on that in just a second. Hey, coming up later this morning, Jeanette Donovan Jones will make her last appearance on the program.
Aww.
She's retiring, or already retired. Teresa Todd, her replacement, will be with us later on this morning, too. And
Mayor Marks will
Mayor Ronnie us. Marks. Ain't seen him in a month. He's supposed to be here today with us, too. Let's see if he makes it.
As you
can see, I'm holding a tomato. Had my breakfast, Frank. Over there with Carol Lynn, had my tomato sandwich and mayonnaise on white bread. Boy, stuff sticks to your teeth, too. We were at Farmer's Market Indicator, bright and early, 9 o'clock Saturday morning. Then went from there, cross country, over to Madison County to the Wing Fest over at Hazel Green High School. Had a good time there. Still got a bunch of wings in there. I got them in the refrigerator this morning, so if y'all want some wings, stop by here and we'll give y'all some. That's what's coming up. Plus, we'll talk about some things happening to Channel 31. We'll keep y'all abreast of that in just a moment. Here's Gloria with the weather.
He's loaded with information today, too, this morning. 62 degrees out there. It feels mighty cool out there. If you like these cool temperatures, get out early this morning. We only have a 20% chance of showers today with high temperatures around 92. Looks like come 5 o'clock, the biggest chance for rain today and then carried on into tomorrow. 50% chance of those showers with high temperatures around 87, and these lows have been low. Let's get back to July and August where it's supposed to be miserably hot that I love. 230-4988 gets Frank this morning.
Hey, Jan, today in USA Today is 07-30-13. You know what that is?
No.
There's the date.
Okay.
That is a monumental date for you folks out there to pay attention to. 1 month from today,
God,
I will be 60 years old.
Goodness.
Mark the calendars, everyone.
1 month from today.
Yeah. Well, good for you. You made it this far.
I haven't killed you yet.
And you're going to talk. No, but you've done a good job. You've done a good job working on it. Huh. 1 month from today, y'all like that? I will be 60 years.
Check out our Facebook like sign.
Yeah.
Isn't that cute?
Yeah. Like one of a kind right there.
Like
I will be. Little Jamie Cooper will be 60 years old.
Well, you're just a baby.
1 month from today.
I think it's
today.
Hard for me to.
Woo! That's
believe
hard.
It.
Hey, 1 month from today. All right, there's a, before I go on to other things, thought for the day, this is by Henry Ford. USA Today's got an article this morning on Henry Ford, made America smaller. But here's a quote, the Decatur Daily, they always do a motivational quote, and it says, you can't build a reputation on what you are going to do.
I like it.
That was Henry Ford, 1863 to 1947. You cannot build a reputation on what you are going to do, Frank. But let's get to my main story this morning. This morning, I was scanning AL.com. Have you heard about this?
No.
Let me get my glasses on where I can see all I need to see here. Shay Allen was fired from Channel 31 yesterday. Here's why. A reporter also told us that this is AL.com, then we'll go to Daily Mail, because she made Daily Mail, too.
Oh, girl.
Has been fired for what she said was a humorous look at her personal blog. Frank, pay attention. Shay Allen, a special investigative reporter, on her blog said, in which many other things, she claims to have gone brawlish during an on-air appearance that drew national attention.
What's wrong with that?
I don't know. We'll talk about that in a minute. Hang on. Said, I do not want to be a joke. I'm a journalist through and through. I believe in what I do. I believe as a journalist, I should be a watchdog. I should be a protector of people's rights. She said that Confessions of a Redheaded Reporter is what her blog is. Now, I don't blog. On Tuesday night after work, station manager called her to the meeting last Friday and said she was terminated. The blog listed 10 confessions. Now, let's switch over here. And I'm going this morning. I go through Daily Mail, which is out of the UK. That's over in London, in case y'all didn't know.
Thanks.
And, it's on there. I'm thinking, well, golly, how'd this get that big a dude? How'd she get all that?
Yeah, I never thought about it as glamorous.
Well, she said, I've gone braless during a live broadcast.
And?
Glamorous TV reporter, fired after telling all, and says, Frank, most of the people she does stories with do it because they have a crush on her. She doesn't like doing stories on old people. Says she slept in the news vehicles before. And goes on, said, I offer no apologies. And it goes on and on. She said, right now, and YTV has not responded with a request yet. Got some photos of her here showing her stuff. It's not the first time she's posted content on her blog that might not be appreciated by her bosses. She posted video speaking to the camera, complaining about how she has been sent on a pointless job and how she got paid very little for the privilege. She said, here's what she says.
She stole some mail or something.
I've gone braless during a live broadcast and no one was the wiser. The comments saying, well, don't say you don't have a whole lot there, evidently.
Well, if you don't know
you,
this.
What you want to say about that? You've done the same thing.
Who hasn't?
What's the big deal? I mean, who cares?
She said, my better sources are the ones who secretly have a crush on me. I am better live and I have no script and no idea what I'm talking about. You'd be good on this program. I think we're hiring us an investigative reporter, Frank.
Yeah, good riddance.
I've mastered the ability to contort my body into a position that makes me appear much skinnier. I hate the right side of my face. I'm frightened of old people, and I refuse to do stories involving them or places they reside. Happy, fluffy rainbow stories about good things make me depressed. I've even taken naps in the news cars. I've stolen mail, then maybe put it back. If you ramble and I deem you unnecessary for my story, I'll stop recording you and let you think. So they could fire her.
Yeah, good.
If y'all knew what we used to do in them news cars, hey,
yeah,
come on.
You were blogging about it.
And you were with management.
Well, yeah. Yeah, I was with management. We didn't have no blog back then. We just bragged about
it.
Yeah.
It was
we, what we smoked in them news cars going up about the 70s and 80s.
Why is that such a big story?
I don't understand.
She's an egomaniac.
Huh?
She's an egomaniac.
Well, some of the comments down here aren't too kind. Let's see. There's 102 of them. She said here, I've gone braless during a live broadcast and no one was the wiser. Doesn't say much for her features if nobody noticed.
Yeah, really.
Says, bye, dummy. Glamorous? Come on, behave. Her firing probably had less to do with her not wearing a bra or seducing sources and more to do with her refusal to do stories with old people and sleeping on the job. If you remain silent, people think you're an idiot, but speak up and you remove all doubt. A perfect example of this reporter's situation.
Yeah, I agree.
Well, man, come on.
Attention, so it must have worked.
By whose definition is a woman glamorous? I tell you what, if anybody sees Shay Allen out today, and she's looking for a job, Jeanette, as an investigative reporter,
come on,
she can work with Frank, and they can go cover Athens and Limestone County.
She's afraid of old people.
Huh?
She's afraid of old people. Frank may never return her.
And Frank says he goes braless all the time.
Yeah.
Just because a woman goes braless on the show and...
Oh, how stupid. Who cares?
Well, evidently Channel 31 did.
Yeah, but she did a lot of other stupid stuff.
They have an abundance of talent, so I'd be trying to keep everybody I could.
That's why we could use her over here. Anybody who's been fired from another position, ask Greg Screws. He did the show. Lee Marshall did our show.
Brad Huffines
has done our show more times
Harold
than we need
Bug.
To. Harold Bugs done our. If you have been misplaced from your current position for no reason except going braless, please give us a call at 603-4848 and we'll put you on TV again.